This is Steve Lentini, and I'm your host for Different Thinking for Different Times. Season 3, Episode 35. Ernest Holmes, in the book Living Without Fear, said, "Each of us is as a unique individualization of the infinite is complete. No two people look alike, act alike, or think alike. No two faces have the same expression. Our fingerprints are different. The emotional reactions of each are distinct and individual. All this in order that individuality may not be lost in the great shuffle of life. The more completely we recognize our individuality, the more unique our personality. Due to this, we commonly speak of persons as being individuals. A psychological reaction against our machine age is an instinctive gesture of a person protesting against anything that would seek to replace the necessity of fully expressing the individuality. As we seek to develop our personalities, we should at the same time try to unify them all with others. That's become one with the infinite, rising above the acorn brain." I love that Ernest says, "A psychological reaction against our machine age is an instinctive gesture of a person protesting against anything that would seek to replace the necessity of fully expressing the individuality." And yet today we see cancel culture making others wrong. We see people blindly following their political parties and just making people who think different totally wrong. It reminds me of some very scary times when despots and despicable people rose to power in many, Venezuela, China, North Korea, Iran, Russia, that have these autocratic leaders and a complete society around one party, one leadership. It really is against the infinite idea. The infinite thinker created all these individuals, right? Each of us is a unique individualization of the infinite. Why are we so small-minded today, thinking everyone has to act like us, think like us, look like us? So Ernest Holmes goes on to say, "As we seek to develop our personalities, we should at the same time try to unify them with all others." So that means acceptance. Acceptance, not rejecting others or one side or make many others wrong. Ernest goes on to say, "Some find their approach to expressing the reality of the center of their being through art, science, or literature, some others through prayer and meditation, but all do it by extended recognition and increased inner awareness. The voice of the spirit speaks to and through all. It is a universal language speaking through many tongues. Einstein tells us to watch the spark that illuminates our own consciousness. This spark is shot from the central fires of the universe and gathers brilliancy within us as we can fan it with our awareness of it. Individuality is the thing behind our personality. Personality is what we make of our individuality. The uniqueness of your personality and of our personality springs from our individuality, which is entirely God-given." That's the rest of the Ernest Holmes reading from Living Without Fear, 1962, pages 20 and 21. So think about that. The individuality is very much like the infinite breaking down, it breaking itself down into many different forms, especially if you consider the trillions and trillions and hundreds of trillions of life forms, many that we can't see, bacterias, single cells, amoebas, small insects, dust mites. And then the things we can see, and perhaps as Lisa Randall has suggested in her work, there are probably as many levels so large that we can't see them, as many as there are so small, which likens to my thought that what my coach has often said, do ants know they live next to a bridge abutment, let alone a bridge? And that's what we humans are, especially when we have acorn brain, small-minded thinking, reacting and not admiring the individuality of all, as all a creation of the infinite, of God, of the divine, of the Brahma, the Buddha, the Abraham, it doesn't matter what you call it, the Muhammad. I was there on November 18th, 2002. As many of you who've listened know. And back in my body, I know that our job is to overcome all small-minded thinking because none of it was there on the other side in what I call what's next. This is a short journey in the physical world, and we have an opportunity to learn and grow and be in awe of all the other life forms. And especially those that upset us and disagree with us because they're mirroring some aspects of ourselves back to us. So those who don't have tolerance for others are intolerant, and yet they might rail against another group's intolerance or perceived intolerance. Fascinating, right? Small-minded thinking. And what's being reflected back to them is their own intolerance. They have what they accuse others of. And I see it in myself. That's where we all have to come to that conclusion, where we get over ourselves. And that's when we learn and grow, when other people's journeys become none of our business and our journey becomes our main focus. If you'd like to be a guest on the podcast, I welcome it. Just email me, steve@stevelentini, that's L as in Linda, ENTINI.com, steve@stevelentini.com. And we'll just talk about where you might have small-minded thinking, where, and I'll readily admit, as I do here, that I have small-minded thinking because it's part of the journey in our physical bodies. But the amazing thing when we pass from this to what's next is that doesn't go with us, which taught me how unimportant it is. There is no title, no accomplishment, nothing from the outside world, no achievement, no material things, no purchases, nothing goes with us from here. And that showed me how worthless outside validation was, living from the outside in, looking for validation through, oh, he's an author, or he's a manager, or a leader, or a vice president. None of that matters except to the small mind, the limited thinker. And remember, if you come on the show as a guest, I might ask you, does that sound like small-minded thinking? And I'll be in awe of whatever your thinking is because it's a choice you've made. And acceptance is my job. I may ask you, how'd you come to that conclusion? Are you open to other ideas? Do you think it makes many others wrong? Does it sound small-minded? But for that, will be your own consideration. I don't want anyone to change. If they choose to change, that's another story based on what they're learning and the information they're getting from infinite thinking. What is the infinite trying to tell you? What is life itself, the creation, the creator, the divine, the God, the goddess, what is it trying to tell you? That's the experience of life in the now, in the moment, because in the infinite, when I went from this to that, to what's next, there was only the now. There was no past or future. Humans have the hubris to think that God thinks like us, or that with our judgments and small-minded thinking that we too think like God, and that's the hubris and the ego of it. It's our job to overcome that, not to believe it. After all, who is the thinker of the thought? So try it, test it for yourself, prove it to yourself that living in a universe, in a miracle, means being in the moment, fully present, especially to the things, the moments and events and people that bug us and bother us. The gift in that is urging you to grow, to overcome small-minded thinking. The divine was in the now. Many people are on a search and a study for God, for the divine, for the goddess, the creator. It's in the now. That's the fascinating thing. Immediately out of my body, I was one with everything and nothing, surrounded by the divine, which words cannot describe, in the now. It was only a now and a now and a now and a now. And that's forever. And while we may come back, since in this world everything's recycled, perhaps in a universe, maybe we come back to experience this life again with holding on to each advance we've made in prior lives. I don't know. I wasn't shown that. I can tell you, there was no small-minded, limited thinking. It's very much unlike what we think is how God thinks. It's very much unlike it. Now, if you'd like to be a sponsor of the show, if you'd like me to sponsor a product of yours, send it to me. I'll consider it. If I can get behind it, if I can believe in what you're saying, I'm glad to sponsor it. I also have another podcast coming. You may be full of shit if, based on my book, you may be full of shit if. And also the second book, which is You May Be Full of Number Two, After All We Know Better, the woke edition. And so there we'll discuss blindly following anything and how it leads to really intolerance and very much small-minded thinking. Right? Just look at the Republican convention or the Democratic convention or the Democratic senators and politicians, and same for the Republicans. Just pointing fingers at each other. We've lost our political process. There's been no gains for many years because we're just stuck making each other wrong. It's small-minded. People are starting to see it. I'm an independent, I'm not afraid to say, only because I look at each individual and I listen for what sound platforms by the person, not by the party. I think it's ridiculous blindly following anything. And I learned how small-minded that is in my time with what's next. And so learn to live every day. Learn to live life. You see how small-minded thinking, humans want to control everybody, mandate things, force people to do things, when really government's role is to guide us, provide us the information, and let each individual make a choice with their bodies, with their lives. And you can see the result of living in fear, people afraid of dying. Death didn't disappear for 300 years, and then COVID brought it back. Millions of people die each year from other things. Over 1.5 million from heart attacks, and another 1.6 million from cancer. And 500,000 people sadly died from COVID the first year, and more this year after everyone was railing against how the previous president did things, and this president is not doing things much better. Small-minded thinking, forcing people, mandating people. And people not being thankful that that vaccines were made in record time. So rather than making our presidents wrong and spending time trying to bog them down, no matter, once an election's over, I support who is my leader as a president because I know we'll get a chance to vote again. We don't have to blindly follow anyone in this country. And small-minded thinking is what that is. So begin to look at where you too can stop blindly following things and become a limitless thinker, infinite thinker, one in line with this miracle we live in, this infinite miracle. We call it a universe and infinite only to give it definition for our small little acorn brains. We have to get over ourselves, but prove that to yourself that it makes a difference in your life. I can say it has for me. Thank you.